तेग बहादुर सिमरे कर नौन दया बताए हर नौन दुआ बताए हर नौन दया बताए।
राग गौड़ी महला नौवा। राग गौड़ी द म्यूजिकल ट्यून द नाइन्थ गुरु श्री गुरु तेग बहादुर जी। साधो एह मन गहयो न जाई। ओ सेंट्स दिस माइंड कैन नॉट बी रिस्ट्रेन्ड। बट व्हाई कैन इट नॉट बी रिस्ट्रेन्ड? गुरु साहब आंसर्स दिस इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन। चंचल तृष्णा संग बस्त है या ते थिर न रहाई रहाओ। फिकल डिजायर्स फॉर मटीरियलिस्टिक ऑब्जेक्ट्स dwell within the mind, and so it cannot remain steady. Pause. This is the central focus of the Shabad. In the first two lines, Maharaj has set out the problem of conquering the mind. Maharaj is saying the problem lays in our pursuit of desires in creation. It is only by seizing these desires that stillness of the mind's concentration can be achieved. If we are to focus, we need to shut out all other thoughts. This concentration will bring one-minded affixation upon God. That is our aim, to become single-mindedly focused upon God. For if we truly want to discover our true identity, we must enable practices that can allow us to see our true reflection. Stillness of the mind brings clarity and will slowly unravel our true reflection and identity as being one with God. Maharaj now clarifies and explains what other vices lead to our spiritual downfall other than desires.
Kathin krodh ghat hi ke pitar jeh sudh sab bisrai.
Extreme anger is within the heart, which causes all sense to be forgotten. This extreme anger is hardened within us. It pours out when unfulfillment of desires is encountered and makes a person lose all sense of reality, causing destructive behaviors and outcomes.
Ratan gyan sab ko hiralina taasyo kach na basai.
This wrath has snatched away the jewel of divine wisdom in all. Nothing can control it. Maharaj further elucidates this point in the next line.
Jogi jatan karat sab hare guni rahe gun gai.
The yogis have tried everything and failed. The virtuous have grown weary of singing God's virtues, yet the mind still cannot be restrained. So if you were to think of yogis adept in breathing techniques called pranayama, many encountered Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji, and Maharaj wrote about these encounters extensively in Sri Japji Sahib, Siddh Ghost, and throughout Gurbani. These yogis tried to convince Guru Nanak Dev Ji to become a yogi, and when they failed, they would try many tricks to scare Maharaj into conversion through the mystical powers they had attained. This was the play of their minds, and at points their anger did spill out due to their ignorance of realizing Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji had come to save and liberate them, rather than be converted by them. Even virtuous people tire of becoming defeated by the mind. But nobody should lose hope, for Maharaj teaches us,
Jan Nanak Har Pai Deyala Tau Sab Bidh Bane Aai.
The servant Nanak says, when the Lord becomes merciful, then every effort is successful. The grace of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji will surely rain down upon us if we make earnest efforts. Our job is to make those efforts and beg for grace. Subsequently, fulfillment will follow, but we must be patient and stubborn in our pursuit of spirituality. Human nature is such that we want spiritual rewards very quickly, but for worldly ones, we toil for years and lifetimes. If you think about your life goals, we put mortgages on properties, we have payment plans for cars and many other things. A mortgage could be anything from 15 to 35 years long. We toil for that many years to fulfill the payments. In the same way, we must have long-term commitments to God. Yes, spirituality is more powerful and rewards may come quicker, but we have to persevere in our pursuit of it too.
in order to not lose hope when things might not go to plan. Raag Gaudi, Ang 219, Sri Guru Granth Sahib Ji.
Tegh Bahadur Simre Karnaunat Yaveta.